But I'm gonna kind of talk about something that everybody has talked about, and it's gonna like play into it. So my story is basically when I was 8 years old, I was kidnapped and raped. It was on my way to school. It was one day, my mom just didn't walk me to school that day. It was one day she didn't walk me to school the very first time, and that's what happened. I got halfway to school, and a guy just walked up to me and grabbed me by the back of my neck and threw me in his car. And he told me that if I kept screaming, I kept yelling, that he would kill me. So I'm on the floor. I don't know where we're going. I can't scream. I can't yell because I'm being told that I'm going to be killed. So he takes me to a parking lot, and he finally is like, okay, you can get up. And I'm looking around like, okay, it's parking lot, where are we? And then he starts touching me. He gets on top of me, and, you know, he does what he does. And then he acts like nothing ever happened. He's just like, oh, yeah, you know, this is my first time doing this. I've never done it before. Your mom told me to do this. And I'm only 8 years old, so I'm thinking, did or did she not tell you to do this? Because this is the first time that she did not walk into school, and this is exactly what happened. And I used to be real talkative, real, like, you know, social. I like to sing, so I used to always walk around and sing and dance around the house. And after this happened, I shut down. Surprisingly, he didn't kill me. He did actually drop me off around the corner from my school, so I walked back to school, and I didn't say anything to anybody. When they asked me why I was late to school, he told me to say my grandpa dropped me off, so that's exactly what I did. I was like, oh, my grandpa dropped me off. And I wasn't going to say anything because he told me not to. And so I was going to keep it to myself. The only reason why I said something is because I bleed easy. So I have a hand mark on the back of my neck that was like a dark purple. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know until one of my friends at school was like, hey, what happened to your neck? And I'm like, what are you talking about? And she's like, oh, you have a handprint, like, on the back of your neck. And I'm like, oh, okay. So that was the reason why I said something after school. So when my mom came and picked me up, like I said, I used to be real talkative, real social. She brought me my jump rope, and she's like, oh, what's wrong? You're not talking, you're not doing anything. And I'm just like, thinking, okay, she's gonna see the bruise on my neck, she's gonna think I got to go fight at school or something. So I'm like, a man grabbed me, and she like, she left me, she took off running. And I'm like, okay. She went home, she called the police, blah, blah, blah. So again, like I said, I don't know 100% if she told this man to do this or not, because this was the first time that she didn't walk me to school, and this is what happened. I only told her that he grabbed me. I didn't tell her about the rape part. I didn't tell her about that part until I was 11. And it was basically because, like I said, he told me not to say anything, and I didn't want to go through whatever the process was that I did. And my message here is just like, don't be afraid to say something. If you feel like something's not right, if you feel like somebody shouldn't be touching you, shouldn't be talking to you, don't be afraid to say something. And that was my biggest mistake, was that I didn't say anything about the rape part until I was 11 years old. And it was basically out of fear. It was out of fear of, I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know what's gonna come from it. And I always felt like, you know, of course, your parent is your parent. You love your parents. You're like, okay, no, my mom would never tell anybody to do anything like that to me. But I wasn't sure. It was always different guys coming in and out the house. So I'm kind of like, I remember one day she tried to whoop me over something so stupid, and that's when I yelled out, well, that's why he raped me. And she was like, what? And I was like, yeah, it wasn't just a kidnapping, it was rape. And she's like, why didn't you say? But she didn't do anything about it. Like, you know, she didn't call the police, she didn't do anything. And I kind of after that was like, well, maybe she did. And I became real insecure. I hated myself. I thought it was my fault. I thought I did something wrong. I became suicidal at a young age. I was like 11 the first time I took me and my cousins. And I hid it. I always would like put on a jacket or something. I didn't have anybody to talk to because I was the baby. wasn't about my family losing me. It was more so, I don't want my friends to lose me, and I don't want to lose my friends. So that's why I appreciate my friends for coming and supporting me. My mom was talking to this guy, and he found me on Facebook, and he inboxed me, and he's like, you know, every time I come to the house, I'm looking at you, you're sexy, you're beautiful, I want to be with you. And I told my mom that, and she told him, and he was like, oh, that wasn't me, that was my cousin. And my mom believed him.
Wow.
So from that point on, I kind of was like, tell him this. But my mom was always one of those people that got on the phone and wanted to tell everybody everything. So even when we would be in the streets in public, she'd be like, yeah, you know, my baby got kidnapped and raped at the age of 8. And it's like, why are you telling complete strangers my business? So even at 29, I still don't talk to my mom about important things because I just feel like she's going to get on the phone and she's going to tell my business. And I should be able to confide in my mom. I should be able to talk to my mom and tell her what's going on in my life. And I just feel like I can't because my business, it should be private. So I've never had a relationship with her to where I just sat down and talked to her and tell her what was going on. And even today, she was like, oh, do you want me to come? And I was like, no, because I was going to say something that would hurt her feelings because this is not, you know, she doesn't know how I really feel. And I don't feel like I'll ever tell her how I really feel because I don't think she deserves to know, because I don't think she put the effort that she should have as a parent in my life. So as I got older, and I did grow up with insecurities, like I said, I went through different phases. I used to, like I said, I wanted to kill myself. I went through an emo phase where all I wore was all black and you couldn't tell me nothing. I went through a phase where I would beat up boys. I went through a phase where I didn't want to talk to nobody. I just wanted to be to myself. And then I also went through the insecure phase where I was like, I don't want to be here. I'm ugly. Nobody likes me. And boys always liked me. Boys are like, oh, you're pretty, you're this. And I'm like, what are you looking at? Like, what girl are you looking at? Because I am not pretty at all. And it wasn't until I turned 24, I did my very first photo shoot. Also helped me to want to help other people because I didn't have anybody to talk to. And I feel like if you have someone who's been through the same situation as you, it can help you cope a little bit better.
All right. Thank you, Miss Shirley.